Hello you wonderful sexy people, this is Chris from Recombu and I'm here with the Moto Z Play and the OnePlus 3T, two great value mid-range phones that you can pick up in the UK right now. Just to do a quick comparison, bit of a head-to-head action to see which is best for you. So, in terms of pricing, £369 here in the UK for the Moto Z Play, £399 for the base model of the OnePlus 3T, so not a lot in it. They're also both 5.5 inches, which is it's pretty big, but you know, it's pretty much standard these days. If you want a mini phone, you're pretty much shit out of luck, to be honest. As you can see, the Moto Z Play is slightly more rounded design than the OnePlus 3T. They're both kind of tricky to use one-handed, but at least with the OnePlus 3T, you do have the ability to pull down the notifications bar from anywhere on the screen, which is quite handy. In a pinch, you can use that. Actual design, as you can see, the OnePlus 3T is actually fairly slender. It's got these nice sort of curved backing, which fits quite neatly in the palm. The Moto Z Play, it goes for more of a flat design, and it is a lot chunkier, as you can see there. The reason for that is because of its modular expansion. So basically, you can prise off this back plate like so, and in there you've got your little dock and everything. What you can do now is you can get a Moto Mod, which is one of Motorola's snap-on accessories, and you can basically attach those to the back of the Moto Z Play and expand the functionality. So for instance, you can add a projector on there, you can add a second battery pack to really boost the battery life, and so on. But in its vanilla form, as you can see, it is quite a girthy little number right there. And of course, it's got this nice textured rear, which does snap on pretty solidly and is held in there by magnets, so it shouldn't fall off accidentally at any point. The camera lens is nice and flush with the surface, whereas it does jut out slightly on the OnePlus 3T, as you can see. And both phones actually support their own fingerprint sensor as well, which is built in just beneath the screen here in the sort of home button area. So if you give that a quick tap, as you can see, it's super fast on the OnePlus 3T, and it's also pretty nippy on the Moto Z Play, only slightly behind the OnePlus. And in both cases, it's very, very accurate indeed. Very rarely get a fail, no matter what kind of funky angle you approach it from. And of course, you can record up to 5 different fingerprints on both phones as well, so you can have some of the users getting involved as well, or you can register a variety of your own prints if you hold it in different hands than the rest, so that's just lovely. The 5.5 inch screen, you get an AMOLED on the OnePlus 3T, and it's a Super AMOLED on the Moto Z Play, but to be honest, the OnePlus 3T's is probably slightly punchier. As you can see here, got the same background, they're both on their maximum brightness, and the yellows and the greens, for instance, are really sort of popping out a lot more on the OnePlus 3T. It's gorgeously vibrant. They're both full HD screens, so as you can see, you really struggle to notice any individual pixels. In both cases, HD movies look absolutely fantastic. You also get great viewing angles, and as you can see, the brightness is strong enough to cope with any kind of glare if we sort of aim it at the windows. You can still see quite happily over any kind of sunlight and other irritating reflections, which is lovely. As for the performance, where you get a Snapdragon 821, the latest Snapdragon packed into the OnePlus 3T, backed by 6 gigs of RAM. And if we go into the AnTuTu benchmarking software, you can see that it performs very well indeed, 164, which is the highest score we've seen on any phone that we've tested. Meanwhile, the Moto Z Play uses the more stripped down Snapdragon 625, which, as you can see, lags far behind. It's almost 3 times lower, the score on the Moto Z Play. That said, both phones do play the latest games absolutely fine, and you can load up apps pretty quickly. There's a bit more of a delay on the Moto Z Play, as you can see, compared with the OnePlus 3T, but it's not like you'll be hanging around all day. We're just hoping that it doesn't show some serious slowdown over the coming months, because some of the other Snapdragon 600 series phones that we've played with, like the Xperia X, for instance, they do show a little bit of lag now that we've used them for a bit, so we've started having to uninstall some of our old apps and the rest. So only time will tell, see how it goes over that. As for storage, you get 32 gigabytes of storage in the Moto Z Play, and you get from 64 gigs, you also now get a choice of 128 gigs on the OnePlus 3T, but it's not quite that straightforward, unfortunately. The Moto Z Play does support micro SD memory card expansion. Just slip it into the SIM tray there, which unfortunately you don't get on the OnePlus 3T. It's one of our features that we would have really liked to have seen. Instead, they just added more built-in storage, so you can't stick a micro SD memory card in to expand that storage, which is a bit of a shame. When it comes to battery life, the Moto Z Play is definitely the winner as well. It keeps you going for a full 2 days, even with really, really heavy use. Whereas the OnePlus 3T, it'll keep you going for over a day, but not much more than that, maybe a day and a half if you sort of stretch it out. But where the OnePlus 3T does excel is its dash charge tech. Plug the Type-C USB into the mains, and it'll get a full charge in just over an hour. Whereas the Moto Z Play, which also supports Type-C, it takes closer to 2 hours. It is really slow despite having this turbo power feature. It's unfortunately a bit crap. So it does take a long time to charge up, which is a bit of a shame. Which brings us neatly onto the camera tech. Both phones boast a 16 megapixel rear camera. And in both cases, it's a super fast snapper. You get a bit of phase detection, autofocus, and all the rest. As you can see, photos take pretty much the instant you tap the shutter button, unless you're in really low light conditions. You get a built-in HDR mode on the OnePlus 3T, and you can also whiz through a various different modes, including full manual controls, which allows you to tinker with the likes of ISO balance and shutter speed. If we swap back to photo mode, the auto mode is perfectly fine though, it really does the job, and you can quickly tweak the brightness levels if needed. If you go into the settings as well, you've got a quick ability to change the aspect ratio and the rest. And you can also dive into the settings here, and you can, as you can see, you can shoot raw images, which is a lovely bonus feature if you like to tweak your photos on the go. And if we swap to the Moto Z Play, you also get a 16 megapixel rear camera. As you can see, once again, it's super fast. The autofocus is absolutely fantastic. You can once again manually focus and tweak the brightness, but that's the limit of your manual controls. You don't have control over the likes of ISO and all the rest of it. You do have an HDR mode though, which is nice in those tricky high contrast situations. And you've got some sort of basic settings. You can change the aspect ratio and the rest as before. Video on both phones, you can shoot up to 4K Ultra HD, which is great news if you've got a 4K telly, because you can actually get some proper content on there. Because the likes of Netflix are now starting to do 4K shows as well. But it's always good to snap your home movies in the latest resolution, and then you can obviously enjoy those for many years to come. And in terms of the front-facing camera, you get an 8 megapixel snapper on both. The Moto Z Play does win for nightclub selfies though, because it does have a front-facing flash, which is not found on the OnePlus 3T. So that in a nutshell is the Moto Z Play and the OnePlus 3T head-to-head. As I say, a very similar price here in the UK. Which one would you buy? Let us know in the comments below. And thanks for watching, everyone. Ta-ra.